Hello, Baycroft. Mr. Mitchell can't be with you today, so I'm afraid at last minute you've got me. But not to worry, because Mr. Kiff has told me what's going on in today's Baycroft TV, and they've got some good stuff coming up. Mr. Jeffrey has got an exercise all about Bill Gates. Mr. Reynolds is going to be talking to you about designing a bowling alley. And Miss Hanukkah has a very special thought for the day. But first of all, here's Mr. Robertson with today's stretches. Enjoy.
Hi guys, so today we're going to be doing something called a side arm raise. And to start off with, we want to keep our feet shoulder width apart as usual. We're going to have our arms out to the side, and all we're going to do is bring them directly up to shoulder level and back down. Up to shoulder level and back down. If it is too easy for you, you can use a weight, but only a very, very light weight. And I only want you to do 3 sets of 30. All right. Take care, guys. See you later.
Good morning, Baycroft. This week we are looking at happiness for thought of the day. And today we're going to be looking at how music can make you feel happy. Now, scientists have been researching for some time now, and there's scientific proof that music can not only improve your happiness and your feelings, but actually it's good for your health too.
Whether you're performing it or listening to it, music can increase your happiness as well as the happiness of those around you. Science has now shown it has a physical effect on our bodies. As we listen, music works on the autonomic nervous system, which is responsible for controlling blood pressure and heartbeat, as well as the limbic system, which is responsible for feelings and emotions. Many scientists believe that if you listen to music every day just for 25 minutes, it will actually help you sleep better at night too. Now, I asked some of the staff at Baycroft what songs made them happy and why. So let's hear what they had to say.
Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me.
Don't worry
about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright.
Singing, don't worry
about a thing, 'cause every little thing gonna be alright.
Don't worry
about a thing.
So share with us what song makes you happy and why.
Good morning or afternoon, everyone. Depends what time you're watching it, really. But I'm filming it in the morning, which is why I start with good morning. But if it is the afternoon, good afternoon. As you may or may not know, I am the undisputed wee bowling champion of Baycroft School. Although there's a student in year nine who will say otherwise. He reckons he's better than me, but I'm telling you, he's not. And he never turned up to our competition we had set up. Again, here tell you I didn't turn up. I did. He wasn't there. You know who you are. I'm not going to say you. I'm not going to call you out on Baycroft TV. I'll see you when we come back to school and we'll settle this once and for all. But anyway, bowling. I'm sure you've all gone bowling before. You know the basics of it. There's 10 pins and you bowl a ball down the lane and get as many pins down as you possibly can. If you don't get them all down in one go, you get a second go. If you get them down in one go, it's called a strike. If you get them all in down in two attempts, it's called a spare. And then other than that, you just count up the numbers that you knock down and it adds up. And then the next person has a go, times that by 10, and then a bonus round if you get a strike or spare, and so on. The rules can be quite complicated, but we all know, and we've all played bowling before, and I'm sure you've all done 10 pin bowling at bowling alleys like Go Bowling. I can't remember the one in Gunwharf's called in Portsmouth. I'm sure some of you have been there as well. But anyway, if you're unsure about what bowling actually is, or if you want to see some awesome strikes, then the next part of this video, you're going to watch about a minute and a half of someone doing a strike challenge. And they're going to see how many strikes they can get in a certain amount of time. So you guys go in and do that, and I'll come back and I'll explain to you what our challenge is after that. See you in a minute. That was pretty awesome to get that many strikes in such a quick time, especially when you've got to wait for the ball to come back and the pins to be reset. I don't think I'd even got one strike in that time. Could put me on the wee bowling, I'll strike every single time I bowl a ball, but in real life I'm not quite as good. So what we're going to do now is we're going to look around the house and find some items that we can use to make our own lane to play at home. Now this is the bit where you're going to need to ask your parents and carers permission, because I've just looked around my house actually and I've just found some things I'm going to use, but they're my daughter's and I had to ask her permission to use them before she went to the beach. I said to her, can I use your toys? And she said yes. So make sure you get permission from whoever owns the toys, but also from the adults in your house, because I don't want you setting up bowling alleys and then throwing balls around the house and stuff and you getting told off. So get permission first, doing some project together maybe. So I'm going to use 6 toys as pins, and I'll show you why we use 6 in a minute. And I've also found something I can use as a ball. So I'm gonna go and set that up, and then I'll show you what we've got.
Hello, so I'm in a new position at the house. These are the objects that I'm going for. So these are the pins using spirit horses. Some of you may have seen the program. My daughter absolutely loves them, but she's got loads of them, so they're perfect for pins for me. So I'm gonna use 6 of these, and I'm gonna set them up like this, and this is why we want 6. We're gonna have 3 on the back row, 1, 2, 3. Then in front of that, we're gonna have 2, 1, 2. And then in front of that, we're gonna have 1, like that. These are lovely horses, by the way, and then 1 at the front. Now the ball is gonna be that little wooden orange from my daughter's kitchen. Now, if you're wondering why we've got 6, think of a triangle that I've set the pins up like a triangle, and they're going to go in front of those cushions so I don't damage the wall. So I'm going to reset these up and then we're going to bowl the ball down and see how we get on. But the best thing actually about these horses, if I find it too hard like this, I can almost turn them so I've got a bigger target to hit. So I'm going to set them up, chuck a few bowls down, see how we get on. I'll catch you in a minute. So my pins are set, the wall's protected by these cushions, and I've got my bowling ball. I'm gonna move up this end now, bowl the ball down, and see if I manage to get a strike. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get a strike, to be honest with you, but we're gonna give it a go. So you're gonna view it from here, and I'll obviously view it from the other end. So wish me luck.
Can't miss the pressure's on. Yes, there we go, that's 3 down. No, that's 4 down, look. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Two to go. With a second go, I don't know if I'll be able to do this. Oh, got one. So that's 5 points on my first go. I'm going to reset them and I'm going to have another go, because remember, in bowling you get two bowls before the next person's turn. So I'm going to set them up again and try again. And I'll change the camera angle this time. You can see me at the other end. You can see me bowl from the other end now. I'm going to use this bow as my marker. I can't put my foot over the line. Same ball, same pins. So I'll get on this time. Oh, I only got two. Got another one with four left. Two down, four left. I told you I wouldn't get a strike, so I haven't got a strike yet, but I'm going to look for other stuff that we can use for bowling alley, see how we get on. So I've had another look around the house and I've managed to find some more things here. As you can see, I've got six different bottles there. Zaflora, some fabric spray, Mr. Sheen, some air spray. Hairspray? Airspray? I don't know what I said then. It's air spray, it's like air freshener. Hand sanitizer and some hand wash for children. And I've also found a soft lead ball. A softball ball. This one here. Look. So that could be a bowling alley as well. And as you can see, set it up in the same triangle that we did with the horses. So you don't have to use toys. You can use bottles and stuff from in your cupboards. But again, make sure you speak to an adult. Well, that's it for the bowling challenge this week. Send in what you've done to the home learning team so we can have a look and check out your lanes. I've just got to work now, as you can see in the background. Well, actually you can't, because it's really bright. I'm going to go record some maths lessons for you all, so I'll speak to you all soon. I look forward to seeing your bowling lanes. See you later.
Today's program. Mr. Mitch will be back with you tomorrow. Enjoy those challenges. Have a great day. Bye.